Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing concept of conformal mapping. We'll see what exactly is mapping and what are the different types of problems in this particular chapter. So friends, before starting with the subject, before starting with the chapter, let us first understand what are the basic curves and how it is formed. I'm sure you are aware about it, but let me revise it quickly because this will be required further in this chapter. So let us start. The first curve is straight line. Let us see how you can draw this. Straight lines. The first line is, let's say, x equal to y. X equal to y means it's a 45 degree line. X equal to minus y is your 135 degrees. Basically, x equal to y is this and x equal to minus y is this particular line. You need to remember it. Next. Suppose you have x equal to 0. What is x equal to 0? X equal to 0 is y axis. So this is x equal to 0. Y equal to 0. Y equal to 0 means x axis. This is y equal to 0. X equal to a. X equal to a is this particular line. That is cutting x axis at a comma 0, and the next is y is equal to b. So this is your y is equal to b, so intersecting at 0 comma b. So this point is a comma b. Let's move on and let's see next type of line, x plus y is equal to 1. Now friends, if you observe here, either you were having x or you were having y, that is x equal to a, y equal to b, but here we do have x as well as y. So what we need to do is, once we'll put x as 0 and we'll put y as 0. So if I'll put x equal to 0, y equal to 1, see x equal to 0, and then I'll put y is equal to 0, then I'll get the value of x equal to 1. So if I draw these two points, 1 comma 0, on x axis it is 1, y axis it is 0, 0 comma 1 is here. So if you draw this, if you join these two points, you will get the line x plus y is equal to 1. Let's check one more example. Let's say you have 2x minus 4y is equal to, let's say, minus 4. Again, basics will remain same. You need to put x as 0 and get y, and you need to put y as 0 and get x. So if you put x equal to 0, this term is 0. So you'll be left with minus 4y is equal to minus 4, so y is equal to 1. If you put y is equal to 0, this term is 0. So you will be left with 2x equal to minus 4, x equal to minus 2. Let us draw. 0 comma 1 will be somewhere around here. On x axis it is 0, y axis on 1. Minus 2 comma 0 will be here. So if you draw these two points, you will get a line, that is 2x minus 4y is equal to minus 4. So I hope you are clear with drawing lines. Let's have a look on the next curve, that is parabola. We need only three curves in this particular chapter: line, parabola and circle. There are four types of parabolas that we are aware about. X equal to y square is equal to minus x, or basically y square is equal to minus x, x square is equal to y, and x square is equal to minus y. These are the four types of parabola. Generally, student gets confused how to draw this parabola. So I'll give you a simple trick to remember this. Whichever is square, y square, so parabola will touch y square, that is y axis, and opening at x means positive x. So it will touch y axis and will open at the positive side of the x. So this is your C curve. Let's look here. This is y square. So whichever square will touch that axis, so it will touch y axis, this is minus x. Negative side of the x, so this is negative x, so that will be y square is equal to minus x is this parabola. Next, x square is equal to y. So here square of x, so it will touch x axis and is equal to y means positive y. This is positive y, this is negative y. So it will touch x axis opening at the positive side of the y. And the last is, it will touch x axis and opening at the negative side of the y. So these are the four types of parabolas that you need to remember. So I explain you with a trick, so you can remember this very easily. Let's move on with the last curve, that is circle. See, there are a lot of other curves also, but in this particular chapter we'll be requiring only three curves. So we understand it, how to draw. There are two types of circle. First is standard circle, and the equation is x square plus y square is equal to a square. That means a circle with the center at origin, that is 0, 0, and its radius is a. So this is one standard circle. Standard circle means this. And the equation is x square plus y square is equal to a square. That is circle with radius a. So this point is a comma 0. There is one more circle, that is, let this is a, this is b. Non-standard circle. See, standard circle means center at the origin. See, this is the center. So it's at origin 0, 0. Therefore, it is called standard circle. If it is non-standard circle, its center will be shifted from origin. And the equation is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, where the center is minus g comma minus f. And the radius is root of g square plus f square minus c. So this is one way of representing a non-standard circle. There is one more way, and it is x minus a the whole square plus y minus b the whole square, let's say, is equal to r square. The center is a comma b. Since x minus a, therefore it is a. So x minus a will be equated to 0, so x equal to a, and this is y minus b equal to 0, that means y is equal to b, and its radius is r. So these are the two ways of non-standard circle. So don't worry, while solving the example, we'll discuss these two equations. So these are the three basic curves that will be required in this particular chapter. First is line, then parabola, then circle. Now we'll see what is mapping. Our chapter is conformal mapping. First of all, we'll see what exactly mapping is. Mapping is very simple thing. Let's say, let me directly give you an example to explain you. Suppose you have function, real function, let's say f of x equal to x square. So we have this function, and we know this f of x is y. So suppose I'm representing it in the set format. So this is set A, this is set B. In set A we'll have x value, and in set B we'll have y value. Y means f of x. So suppose x value is 1, 2 and 3. So if you put x as 1, that means here y value will be 1 square is 1. If I'll put 2, 2 square is 4. If I'll put 3, that is 9. So this is the mapping. And these two functions are mapped through this, that is f of x equal to x square. So this is your mapping. For different values of x, what are the different values of y, and what is the relationship between them? So this is the basic example. Here we are mapping real values. But the problem is, our chapter says it is conformal mapping. It is not mapping. Conformal mapping is a part of complex analysis, where real and imaginary part will be there. So friends, we'll exactly see conformal mapping in the next videos. For this video, let's discuss what are the different types of conformal mapping or different types of problems involved in this particular chapter. So friends, first is standard transformation and the second is bilinear transformation, in which also we do have cross ratio property with fixed point, and the second is mapping of BLT. So these are the two types of problems in this particular chapter. Now, standard transformation means, see, there can be number of types of transformation. I'll give you a few examples. For example, translation, for example, rotation, magnification, inversion. There are number of transformation. We all categorizing it as standard transformation. And there is one more types of transformation, that is bilinear transformation. That is our next type. So these are the two types of problem. And as far as exams are concerned, bilinear transformation is very important. You can expect at least one problem, and from standard transformation also you can expect one problem in the exam. So number of transformations are there: translation, rotation, magnification, inversion, bilinear transformation, in which also we are more focusing on bilinear transformation, and rest of the transformation we are categorizing at standard transformation. So in the type 1 we'll see standard transformation, in type 2 we'll see bilinear transformation. So let us start discussing type number 1, that is standard transformation. So friends, these are the steps for solving standard transformation. Your problem will always be given in terms of W is equal to f of z. As we have discussed in complex variable, whenever you get W, you're going to replace by U plus IV. And whenever you get Z, you're going to replace by X plus IY. So this is replaced by U plus IV. This is replaced by X plus IY. We'll solve this. We'll equate this. We'll get the value of U and V. And we'll draw. So basically, friends, what we are doing is, in conformal mapping chapter, we converting a problem from Z plane to W plane. We converting problem from Z plane to W plane. For example, suppose there is a line in Z plane. Z planes means X plus IY, and W plane means U plus IV. So Z plane is X and Y, and W plane is U and V. So suppose in Z plane it is a straight line, let's say X equal to Y. It quite possible that in W plane it will be a circle. So it depends upon the transformation that you are using here. So a line may get converted into a circle, or it's quite possible a line will remain a line but equation will change. So it depends upon the transformation that you are using. So the chapter is divided based on this particular transformation. So we divided the chapter into two types based on this transformation: standard transformation or BLT transformation. So this transformation can be standard, means it can be translation, rotation, magnification, inversion, or it can be bilinear transformation. So in the next videos we'll see how the image will be transformed by using standard transformation. Thank you.